Florida, Florida State. Michael Brooks, one of the great linebackers in Seminole history, playing his final game at home. Chief Osceola at midfield. The scene is set for one of the great rivalries in the history of college football. A beautiful Saturday afternoon in Tallahassee, and ABC Sports welcomes you to the CFA Classic. Florida, Florida State, that says it all. His first pass, complete to Kez McCorvey. McCorvey, a pass midfield, first down Seminoles. Into Florida territory, on the toss, Dunn behind the tight end, slips Carter, gets to the corner, and close to the first down marker where Larry Kennedy is able to bring him down. Can they make another stand? Dunn's going to give it a try. First down easily. Daylight, Dunn to the 21-yard line. Job back, and this would be a 35-yarder. And Maui puts the Noles up by a field goal. An empty formation. Five receivers go out. And Werfel to Jackson, but there are penalty flags down.
They blew the coverage.
Middle's open. Got him. Held on a foot race to the end zone. Touchdown, Florida. 68 yards to Aubrey Hill. Some of you might remember Steve Spurrier wearing number 11 when he won the Heisman at Florida. Brought it out of retirement for Hanks. Pinnell's got a man. Inside the 25-yard line, Omar Ellison from Griffin, Georgia. Corner blitz by Lott. And they're faked the end around, and Preston Banks fumble! The Gators recover.
12 yards of carry. What it does for man-to-man, it has some of the defender chasing the fake man. Doesn't matter if you fumble it, though.
Short drop, basically a control running play. Jackson for the first down. Here's the empty formation. They scored off it the last time they were able to hit a receiver. This time it is going to the 46-yard line and a first down for the Gators. Third knockdown of a pass. And on second and 10, Werfel again from the other side, away from Abraham. Throws complete to the 31-yard line, and a Gator first down with Aubrey Hill, 19 yards. And after the 5-yard penalty, Werfel fires complete to Jackson. Jackson twists and spins. First down. Wonderful run after the reception by Jackson before Hamlet can bring him down. Werfel rolls in that direction. Jackson, touchdown, Florida. Steps away from the pressure, drops it off to his tight end, Sean Nunn, and Nunn inside the 15, close to the 10-yard line. Give him a 35-yard field goal. The men up front are simply doing the job on the rush. They come again, Cannell, ball is loose, and Florida pounces on it. That was Kevin Carter on the loose ball, and this defensive line is simply dominating the Seminoles front.
As well, four down linemen coming real hard, trying to pick Carter up with a fullback. All right, here comes an inside rush. They come around to the outside. Now they're scrambling for the ball. Carter's still on his feet. He can make the play.
Werfel to run the quarterback draw. Werfel sprints free, fumble. He goes back on the loose football. And on first and 15, Werfel hit on the release. Underthrow Fuller with the interception. Fuller now circling left. Cuts back to the middle of the field. There is a penalty marker all first half. Pinnell off a fake. Hit on the release, going deep down the middle. It is intercepted at midfield. Gilmore, and the free safety swings free, wants to lateral it, and he does. And now Lawrence Wright circling back. This is a mistake. It has taken him away from a possible field goal. Can you believe it?
Give the interception credit to Kevin Carter. Outstanding. outstanding pass rush that.
Here's the tail end of the play right here.
That's Larry Kennedy working on it right there. Then Gilmore, the safety, comes over and makes the play. Now, he's a bright guy, academic All-American, going to go to med school, and he actually makes a dumb play right here. He's going to get a little too smart. Here you are, your turn. You take it there, Lawrence.
Michael will love this line, but maybe I'll get a second opinion after he gets the doctor's. Okay. Michael, it's going to happen. Hey, trust me. I've seen guys ladle the ball. Werfel takes it, and because of the college rule that the clock is stopped, they will get a few seconds, but they've got to hurry back down there as Hill gives them a first down. Then they can still stop the clock after the 21-yard gain. Werfel, Jackson, got it! Tech Texas! Woo! A little bit later tonight, the Notre Dame game. Danny Cannell deflects it and complete. Well, that's one way to do it, to the 35-yard line, and is McCorvey.
Fast break level.
Here's that draw.
That inside handoff to Preston on that draw look.
I've been waiting for that one, Brent, because the tackles are taking an outside rush. I'm not sure they did it that time, but they have been, and I think that's why that was called.
And now up over that middle, Ellison inside the 10, fumble. And the Gators pounce on the ball, but they're going to call it down. I think you saw that official run right through your picture. On second and 10, Werfel down the middle. Complete and inside the 20-yard line to Anthony. Werfel over the top for the touchdown. No one expected Florida to come in here and dominate, I don't believe. There's the pressure. That's what's done it. There's the most valuable part of this Gator team right here is that defensive line. What do you think? Does Florida belong in that same group? Well, we're going to find out, aren't we? Swing pass now. Preston claws for a first down. Down. Cannell firing to the 16-yard line, and McCorvey 31-3 on the board, and Cannell firing to the 5-yard line, and McCorvey, the fullback, touchdown Seminoles.
They ran a trap.
Cannell off a play fake to the tailback. The middle's open, and he's got McCorvey. McCorvey is loose inside the 30 to the 25. Offensive line and their inability to deal with the rush. Safety valve is there, and so is Mr. Dunn. Out of bounds at the 7-yard line, and the Noles attempting to mount a fourth quarter comeback. Cannell takes the snap and rolls off to the right. Now they must hurry. Fires a touchdown. Hits Cooper in the corner. 10:04, and hang on, everybody. Here come the Noles. Up against the Gators. Swing, and his tailbacks have been lethal coming out of the backfield. That time it's Preston. If it's not Preston, it's done. What great hands these two running backs possess here in Tallahassee. It's 3rd and 4. They've got 2 downs to get the first down. They get it on the first one by again using Dunn out of the backfield. It'll be 1st and goal for the Noles at the 5. Off the penalty, half the distance, 1st and goal, the fake of the inside handoff. Cannell's going to run for the touchdown. Touchdown, Florida State. Werfel fakes the swing, comes back underneath, and there's that man again.
Don't go out of bounds.
Anthony slips out on that far side. 2nd down and 13, and Werfel on the release. Colsey, diving grab. At the 40, interception, Seminoles ball.
They put the back in the backfield for protection back there. They get time right there early, and he throws it out wide to the right. A long throw. Must have been a receiver communication break.
Knee injury, and for Cannell, finding Dunn, crosses midfield, breaks free, out of bounds. is at the 23-yard line. The staff blitz. Has to make it up against the blitz. Touchdown, Florida State. Now, Cannell. Clock starts. Right sideline. Got him out of bounds at the 48. 17 seconds, McCurvey. The 8-yard line, 17 seconds. Cannell steps up against the pressure. Got to get the first down to stop the clock. And
he didn't
get it. The clock is going to continue to run with 10 seconds. He's got to stop this baby.
Line up and down it.
He's got to down it. It's going to run out on him. Didn't do it. This game is over. A 31-31 tie. And Steve Spurrier comes across the field, shake Bowden's hand, and let's go down to Jack Aroo. Jack.
Coach, what a tremendous comeback, but tell us your thinking about going for the tie and not a two-point conversion.
Oh, it's been too good of a comeback to risk losing a game. I wasn't going to do it. Let them try to come back, and we get the ball and score. We still thought this time enough to win it.
Do you get one any tougher than this when you told your guys at halftime that what you were going to do was try to remind them about last week's Alabama-Auburn game? This one came out with a tie instead of a loss.
Well,
though.
Alabama had Auburn 21-0. They came back, and then Notre Dame beat. We've lost several quarters of play. We lost the second quarter in this ball game, and then they beat us the third quarter, but I thought we won the fourth.
Does this qualify as one of those moral victories?
No, I don't think so. I don't think Steve or myself, either one of us, would want a moral victory against the other, but it is a pretty dang good win. I mean, tie. Pretty good tie.
But does he say what he means or means what he says?
Thank you very much. Dick Vermeil.